Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the Roron email worm. This worm surfaced in November of 2002 in Bulgaria and quickly gained about 36 variants of itself, all of them minor changes between version to version, changing things like the email text, the file names that it spreads as, and the error messages that appear. You can see we have a few different variants here. We have 4 on the desktop. These are all very slightly different, and in my testing, I'm not sure which one actually does the destructive routine, so we are just going to infect this machine with all 4 variants and see what happens. Now, this is an email worm, so I have Outlook open, we have some fake contacts set up, and this worm is also supposed to delete antivirus executables when they are found, and I've never tested this part, so we're going to see live what happens. I have my very cool antiviruses here. We got fprot, we got Norton antivirus, and we've got the Panda antivirus. All very effective and actual antiviruses, I assure you. So let's go ahead and kick this off. We'll start with this first one up here. Looks like a WinZip self-extractor. And we see WinZip self-extractor license confirmation. Your version of WinZip self-extractor is not licensed, or the license information is missing or corrupted. Please contact the program vendor or the website for additional information. And this is a fake error message. You can see we got the hourglass as the worm begins to search through your hard disk, find the locations where it's going to drop its files, and set up all of its registry keys to be able to run on boot up. So now that that's infected, it actually sets up a mutex in memory, which will not allow other variants of itself to run or its own self over and over. So if I run this, oh, I guess this one works. Cannot open file. It does not appear to be a valid program. If you downloaded this file, try downloading file again. Yeah, Windows. That sounds like Windows to me, right? That's perfect grammar. Well, anyway, so now we're infected with that one. But this one will not run again. So now that the worm is in memory and running, you don't see the same error message twice. Let's try this other variant. These two might be the same. They have the same icon, so let's try this one. No, okay, so that one we don't see the error message on. Let us go to Task Manager, just real quick. And notice we're not seeing any emails, which kind of sucks. I was hoping we would, but that looks suspicious. And that looks suspicious. So we're gonna get rid of those. And we're gonna run this one. So there we go. Error starting program. The C documents and settings, Danoct 1 desktop, expects a newer version of Windows. Upgrade your Windows version. And now this is Windows 2000, and this worm is from 2002, so I mean, the only newer version I could get would be XP, but whatever. So we are infected now, and I'm going to show you the registry keys that this creates, as it does something kind of nefarious. You kind of see it in a few other worms that sometimes do something like this. So we're going to go to hkey local machine. We'll just see the startup ones real quick. The classic Microsoft Windows current version run. So over here, let's see what we've got. Accessories 32.exe. We've got Windows NT 16.exe launching itself, and we have run DLL 16. Load current profile. We have 2 of those, and it looks like both of these are probably worm files. They don't look like they should be there running on startup, but I'm not an expert. I'm just an end user. The next thing to show you, we come up here, we go to hkey. Classes root, and then to exe file. Shell open command. And here we go. Okay, I have to scroll over and see it. I was expecting a new key besides default, but every exe file that runs on this machine is now hooked into run dll16.exe. So if we actually just go in and just delete the worm's file, none of our programs will launch anymore. It'll say you can't run this exe file because it cannot find the worm anymore. So it kind of becomes codependent with everything on your machine. Everything has to go through the worm first, and then it'll launch your program. So programs still work. If we come in here, go to, let's just run solitaire. So it runs the worm, and then it runs your program. So programs still work, but you are infected. Now, I couldn't find a good old copy of Kazaa, but this worm actually looks up its registry information for your shared programs folder in Kazaa. If you remember or you ever used it, you would have one folder in your Kazaa installation you would set up as your shared folder, and that's where it would find programs to share on the peer-to-peer network. Programs, music, movies, viruses and worms, whatever it might be. And Roron would find that and then copy itself using one of the names on this list you see here. Now, this looks like exactly what you would see in any given search when looking for anything on Kazaa or LimeWire. So it's no surprise that Roron also goes through this method. And I really would like to see the emails, but it doesn't look like it wants to send anything, unfortunately. So just in case that doesn't work, here is an example of one of the emails it sends. And of course, it's exactly as you would expect, some nonsensical thing that tries to entice you into launching its executable that is attached. It's probably a really good thing that most email clients no longer allow you to attach any executable files whatsoever, or stuff like this would probably still be spreading pretty regularly. I'm going to restart real quick just to see if that kicks off the email routine, and we will be right back. Oh, so the worm activated its random payload, which is to remove a bunch of important files on the drive, and pretty much kills your machine. So now I have to reinstall Windows. Maybe I'll install Windows 98 and see what the worm does on there. Maybe we'll just go with one variant this time. Alright, and we are back. This time we are on Windows 98 Second Edition. Now, I started recording this early this morning before the sun came up, and now here I am again late this evening after the sun has gone down so that I can finish making this video because the worm decided to activate randomly. Now, its payload activates with very specific criteria. It can be on the 9th or the 19th of any month, if its DLL file is removed or its registry run keys are removed, or, as we saw, randomly. So according to certain random internal counters, the worm can just decide to wipe everything, and it deletes everything on all available drives. And I'm not quite sure what it did, but it somehow screwed up the other drive on this machine so hard that I had trouble booting from the floppy disk, and eventually had to boot from a Windows 95 boot disk to reset the partitions and very slowly begin to piece together the system so that I could finally install Windows 98 and get this video over with. Now, I did try the email routine on here with Outlook Express. It still didn't work. I'm not sure what's up with it, what it requires for it to actually send. Maybe it needs an active internet connection, which I don't have on here. At any rate, the emails didn't work. Maybe at some point in the future I'll set up another dummy email server and get a couple of computers together talking to each other just to see if we can get some of these email worms to work properly, this one and some others. It's always fun to see the malware work the way it's supposed to work without me just describing it to you. And last but not least, this worm. We'll go ahead and run it. So, still works just fine, missing or corrupted. Alright, let's see if it drops some files. But this worm will also drop some malicious IRC scripts on your machine in order to open up a backdoor to an attacker. So this might be another cool thing to take a look at. I don't have any way currently of hosting an IRC server, but I should really do some research. So make sure you encourage me to get off my butt and actually start figuring out how to do all this stuff, because that would be pretty cool to see. So I mentioned deleting the DLL would trigger the file deletion. So here's the DLL, winfile.dll. We'll try deleting this just to see if it actually works. I have not tried deleting this to see if it will then delete everything. I mentioned that I had another drive, so here it is, and I have some very important files on it, as you can see. And I really don't want to lose these, so we're going to hope that Roron does not actually activate when I delete this file. So let's find out what happens. I want to send it to the recycle bin. Yes. Whoa! Did you see that? That was fast! There goes the desktop. It hit everything in that folder immediately. A fraction of a second. Well, I can still run my very important file, so it's good it did not touch my D drive this time for some reason. But Windows just got completely obliterated in an instant. The quick launch is gone. Oh, we have Batmeter 16. Oh, that's gone. Never mind. Oh wait, config manager. So here, okay, that's kind of neat. It's deleting. Seems to be in a loop deleting files, and it's replacing itself with various names from its names list. So these are the files that you would have seen in Kazaa's share directory or attached to emails. It could pick a random one of any one of these. So if we just sit here for a bit, we might actually see a few more names pop up of what it tries to tempt you with. Now, I'm not sure with the ones it drops in the system directory if they have some of the more enticing names like the Eminem album or whatever it was, or the GTA crack, I don't remember. This appears to be just generic file names. DSound 16, ADVAPI 3232. But it's going through them. I mean, it's deleting its own file and replacing it over and over again. All the rest of these, I'm assuming, cannot be deleted. What happens if I try? Yeah, it's being used by Windows. So the worm can't touch the files that are in use, but its own file copy dropped in here is not in use, so it's constantly replacing it. The D drive still seems to be functional. If I close and go in, yeah, alright, still here, that's cool. Alright, so my very important file survived, but nothing else appears to have. Oh, we're getting multiple copies of it in here. That's kind of neat. Is there another one here? Yes, there is! Okay, so three copies in the system directory. Pretty sure it does some stuff in program files. It, like, picks a random folder in here. Net meeting empty. Online services. Nothing. So everything has pretty well been wiped out. And like I said, that file deletion payload seems to be happening in an infinite loop. So if I make a text document, does it stick around? Oh, it's still here for now. That's good. Can't open it, but I made it. Oh, no, never mind. So let's time that. Let's see if I make a bitmap. So that's around for like 1, 2, 3, 5, maybe about 10 seconds worth of, not even 10 seconds. So yeah, that's cool. Recycle bin, nothing. That's really all I can show you, so let's see the result of the destruction. Alright, we post it, and of course we get invalid system disk, replace the disk, and then press any key. So there you have it, that's the Roron worm in a nutshell. We saw some weird stuff happen, we couldn't get a lot of the weirder stuff to happen, but we have some goals to work for in the future. A saying that's been bouncing around in my mind lately has been, perfection is the enemy of good. So in the pursuit of perfection, you can let just good enough not be good enough. And that's kind of the philosophy I'm trying to take to these videos. I mean, I've been doing this for over 15 years, and I really can't expect a home run every time. Like, honestly speaking, right now, talking to you directly, this video right here, I'm not super proud of it. Nothing really went quite the way it was supposed to go. And it wasn't even fun and entertaining the whole time, like with Ka or something like that, where everything just goes off the rails. This one was just, I don't know, it's kind of lame, but I hope you enjoyed watching it anyway. What I try to make it palatable, digestible, and entertaining. That is my goal with every one of these videos. I never want someone coming away from it saying, I didn't like that, or that was boring, or I had no idea what was going on. I'd really like some degree of entertainment, and I hope the weirdness in this worm was enough that you were entertained. But at any rate, if you watched this long, I really appreciate you sticking around. It means a lot to me. And I never like to promise anything because who knows if I can actually stick to it these days. But I do have quite a few new acquisitions in terms of old, weird software, security software, monitoring software, stuff like that, which I think might be pretty cool to take a look at, which I'm going to try to get to in the very near future because I really would like to demonstrate some of this stuff. And I think I've got a great plan ironed out for looking at these old antiviruses. We're going to be running a battery of tests on them and just kind of going over everything in the box. So I hope you're looking forward to that. And I hope I can stick to my word and get some of these videos done and out. Because even though it's been 15 years, I still don't want to stop doing it. And as long as you're enjoying watching, I'm going to keep making them. So that's about it for the Roron email worm. Thank you very much for watching. Take care.